The largest titanosaurs have a very strong fossil record in South America, and specifically in Argentina's Patagonia region. However, for a few years now, there's been discussion about large sauropod fossils coming from the other side of the planet, and they've only just now been described. Originally found in 2004, Australotitan cooperensis was from the Winton Formation and comes from the massive Aramanga Basin within central Australia. It would have lived during the Cretaceous and potentially alongside other sauropods which were also found in the Winton Formation, including animals like Wintonotitan, Diamantinosaurus, and Savannosaurus. But unlike those others, Australotitan really leaned into that Titan part of the name because it was absolutely massive, potentially as large as some of the largest dinosaurs that have ever existed. Depending on which bone is being measured and compared to other animals, Australotitan plots with a lot of the largest sauropods to have ever existed, such as Dreadnoughtus, Parallotitan, and Phutalognocosaurus. This means that Australotitan is the largest dinosaur that we know of to have ever been found in Australia. And again, it was rivaling the largest dinosaurs ever known, so it wasn't just it that was reaching these sizes. This means Australotitan could have been over 30 meters long, or about 100 feet, although weight estimates vary a lot with all of these species, from only a measly 26 tons, all the way up to 82 tons, which a measly 26 tons is still a lot of weight, don't get me wrong. These things were absolutely massive. For comparison to a modern day animal, elephants can weigh anywhere between 2 to 7 tons, so even at the smallest weight estimate, these animals still weigh as much as an entire herd of elephants. So again, they were bigger than anything the land has ever seen before or since. But Australotitan isn't very closely related to these other massive sauropods. Instead, it forms a pretty distinct clade with the other Australian taxa, meaning that whatever they were doing in Australia was still distinct from even the larger species in South America and other continents. That being said, that it's closer to these species, though, it isn't necessarily just a large version or large individual of one of those other species, and that's because of a few specific features. There's a distinct ridge on the lower half of the humerus, and an extra projection on the humerus as well. And that's essentially the majority of the differences because Australotitan is a very fragmentary fossil, but those kinds of very specific differences can give a good understanding to researchers for how exactly an animal was built and how it is different from its closest relatives. So it is its own distinct genus, Australotitan. And as for how the researchers were able to find this, it's actually pretty interesting because they didn't necessarily go to different museums and look at all the fossils themselves. Instead, they used a number of 3D scanning techniques to compare all the fossils side by side and be able to digitally mark on them different structures. Now, this kind of 3D scanning has been done in some limited capacity in the past, but because travel was so limited last year with the pandemic, these researchers were forced to try and do this kind of scanning and comparison all digitally. And that means that this paper actually sets up a very good guideline of how to use these methods to do other research down the line. So this is a paper that we'll probably see cited in a lot of things that aren't necessarily related to the largest dinosaurs.